Morning guys, and welcome back to my channel. It is a Wednesday here in Sydney and I am just about to go off to gym. I just showed you guys my morning routine that I have been jumping back on. I really noticed that my skin and my digestion hasn't really been on point lately. It's because I stopped doing all of these little steps that I used to do of a morning that I found really aided in my digestion and my gut health. But first of all, show you my pre-workout. I'm gonna head off to gym and hit some legs and I'll be back to update you. We don't sleep when the sun goes down. We don't waste no precious time. All my friends in the loop. And I just wanted to take you through my post-workout meal and just what I'll be doing today for this vlog. So what I'll be doing is taking you through my what I eat in a day. It's something that I do get requested and asked a lot. So I thought I'd show you. Also, I'm going to take you through my little bit of a game plan for a mini shred that I'll be doing over the next 2 weeks before I go to Hawaii. So I go away to Hawaii in 2 weeks from tomorrow, which I am super excited about. Kyle got me a flight for my birthday last September, so I've been super excited. I've never been before, but because I know I don't like to restrict myself when I'm on holidays, and I like trying all the new foods, and obviously I'm gonna have a drink when I'm over there. I'm just going to do a mini shred. It's not gonna be anything too crazy because some of you might know, but I prepped for a fitness competition for 6 or 7 months last year. So I only really feel like my body's resetting and everything's kind of getting back to normal now. So I really don't want to put any extra pressure on my body or put myself on too strict of a diet or in any sort of like crazy deficit. So what I'm going to be doing is just a really little mini shred, and it's just really cleaning up my diet and getting back on track with my training after the new year. So I'll just be taking you through my little game plan, what I'll be doing, as well as just making sure that I'm doing these types of steps like of a morning to help my digestion and my liver and my gut health and stuff like that, so that my skin's nice and clear. That's one thing that I do notice when I'm eating like gluten and dairy and that type of stuff. I get really bad breakouts. Also lately I have been having hormonal breakouts, which has been really frustrating. I had a really bad skin as a kid, and that's actually why I went on the pill when I was younger, and I was on the pill for like 8 years and it completely screwed me up. Like, how is it even legal? Anyway, that's a whole other thing, but if for those of you, I'm sure I'm gonna get asked now, I have the Implanon, the like rod in your arm, and that's worked really well for me. This is my second one. I've had it for years and years and years, but I have noticed lately I've been getting really bad hormonal breakouts like down here, and yeah, a few other like little things. I think I need to get it taken out and put a new one in, so I'll be going to the doctors later. So today's all about running errands, but I thought I would show you first of all what I eat in a day, and then also take you through my little game plan for when I want to like cut down or shred down for an event or a holiday or something like that. I just want to get really motivated, smash out these next 2 weeks before Hawaii. So I just wanted to show you my post-workout. So pre and post-workout, I like to have proteins and carbs, especially when I'm doing weight training. So my post-workout meal I'm about to make now because I am so hungry, but I'm going to make basmati rice, tuna, and egg whites. And yeah, I'll show you how I make it, and then I will sit down and do more of an update with you all. So while I am making the eggs, I thought I would show you how I track. It's something that I get asked a lot about tracking. So I don't always track, and I think it's really healthy to have breaks from tracking your macros, is what I'm talking about. If you watched my last YouTube video, go check it out. I talk about macros and like clean eating and blah, blah, blah. I have figured out my macro, like my maintenance, and then what I need to be eating and what macronutrients I need to be hitting to reach my goals. So I just wanted to show you guys what I use. I use MyFitnessPal, as you can see here. So you just go into diary. It's really easy to use and you can learn a lot about foods. However, of course, there's downfalls like there is to everything. So it's kind of like Wikipedia, like people can put their own calorie amounts in there. So make sure when you're using it, you are, I think the best way to do it is by clicking on, just there, you can see mine so far, clicking on add food, clicking the scanner, grabbing like whatever you're using. I'm using these rice cups because I'm lazy and I usually have no time. Don't judge. And I scan the back and then it will come up with your exact brand and you just know that that is going to be the right macros. Just check the serving size and make sure if you're having the whole serving, that's what it is. Otherwise you can change your serving size. So you'll add that and then I'll do that again with my tuna. The tuna that I like to use is this one. I do find that it is the best if my camera ever focuses. So again, I'm just going to scan that. So I'll just make that now, I'll quickly show you. And yeah, that's how I track. So that is my lunch. It's just the tuna, egg whites, pumpkin, and asparagus and rice. And I just wanted to say something that I do is I keep veggies in the fridge. So I can just kind of add a little bit. Usually I try to do 70, 75 grams of veggies in every meal if I can. So yeah. All right, guys. So I just wanted to update you on my training and nutrition and what I'm going to do for my mini shred for Hawaii. So this isn't anything crazy for me. Like I said before, it's just a really small shred. And I just wanted to give you a couple of the things that I do when I'm trying to shred down for like a photo shoot or an event or maybe like a holiday for this example. And it all really comes down to just fine tuning your nutrition and training. So I haven't been being very consistent with my diet and with my training. It's been the silly season, that's totally okay. You can't be perfect all year round. So it is really important to recognize and have a goal to then train towards and stuff like that as well. So what I'm going to be doing is just a couple of things. So first of all, I'm going to make a plan, which I have done. I've got 2 weeks, I wanna lose a little bit of body fat, but keep and maintain my muscle mass and keep my performance and strength up in the gym. So I'm only going to go into a very slight deficit and then refeed every couple of days. So every 4 or 5 days, go back up to maintenance and make sure my body doesn't get used to or adapt to the lower calories and cause any metabolic or hormonal damage. So number one is tracking. I need to make sure that I'm tracking and hitting my macros to my goals to make sure that I'm gonna get there at the end of the day. Number two, increasing my water, doing all of my gut health routine like what I showed you this morning. That's gonna aid in digestion and also water retention and my skin, all that type of thing, which is another few things that I've been having issues with lately. Again, it just comes down to my nutrition. I feel like I've been holding a lot of water and a lot of fluid lately. That's probably all the sodium in the fast food and stuff I've been having, all the processed foods. So I just need to really fine tune my nutrition. So go back to eating and volumizing through vegetables and stuff like that. The next one would be fine tuning my training. So with my training, I'm going to be doing predominantly weight training. That's what I find that my body responds to most. So I'm going to be doing 5 to 6 days of training, mostly weight training, maybe 1 or 2 HIIT sessions at F45. I'll try and incorporate weights into those sessions as well. And I'm gonna try and do abs about 3 to 4 times a week as well. We know what I need to do, I've got a plan. I also need to make sure that I'm having rest days. So I'll have 1 rest day a week. Sometimes I'll even have 2. It literally, I'll just listen to my body and see how I'm feeling. Make sure that I'm supplementing correctly, taking my magnesium. And yeah, all it is it's really simple, guys. It's just fine tuning those little things like your diet and nutrition and just sticking with it. So being consistent. I'm off to an appointment now. I'm running out of time today. So I'm gonna go off to my appointment. I'll show you what I'm gonna make for lunch first. And then I'll see you later tonight. So I have just heated up my lunch.
All this is really lean organic beef mince. I also really like using turkey mince, and I put some zucchini and also some broccolini in the mix with sweet potato on top. And I'll just show you the sauce I used. This is the sauce that I used. I like using this one because, as you can see, the only ingredients is the diced tomatoes and tomato juice. So it's all natural and it's really low in sugar.
Alrighty, so I am back from my appointment. Thank God for daylight savings. I have been rushing around all day today, but what I'm going to do is now just show you what I'm going to make for dinner. And then I'm finally gonna sit down and relax and Netflix.
So these are just my ingredients for dinner. We've got your pesto, and then the chicken, zucchini pasta.
I'm just gonna wrap that vlog up here, guys. So if you enjoyed the video, please give it a big thumbs up. Please like and subscribe to my channel, and please comment any video suggestions below, or if you had any questions, just chuck some comments below and we can start to have a bit of a chat. So that's it for now, guys, and I'll see you guys.